This right here is an entire replica of every city and geological feature of Earth in Minecraft. And this is a robot made with artificial intelligence that learned to play the game all on its own. These are just a few of the greatest accomplishments ever achieved in the game's history. But let's start off with a 1 million gold block cube built completely in survival. The SciCraft Minecraft server is known for pushing the game to its absolute limit. And in this case, dominating the global economy is no exception. With the help of this complex AFK pigment farm built in the Nether, the members gathered over 100 million gold nuggets from just the farm alone. Then, because nobody wants to make a storage unit for that many nuggets, they turned them all into gold blocks, which they then used to build a gigantic golden cube that almost goes up to the sky limit. Oh boy, that is just the start of the greatest Minecraft accomplishments though. Check out this guy who single-handedly went ahead and drained out an entire Nether lava ocean in survival mode. To complete this project, he set up piston circuits to push sand into a lava lake very quickly, and then after all of the lava blocks had been covered by sand, he would remove them all with torches. Then by rinsing and repeating the strategy for over 4 whole months, he removed all of the lava out of this Nether ocean, and I'm not sure why somebody would willingly do this to themselves, but you gotta respect the man's grind. Alright boys, now let's move into the more crazy side of the accomplishment. A YouTuber by the name of Fast Jazz figured out how to farm the Ender Dragon repeatedly while being completely AFK using this giant contraption in the end. Basically, you turn on this TNT duper above the farm, then literally all you have to do is look down into this water and hold right click with a finger or a rock. Then the water will push you around while you resummon the dragon with the crystals, which activates an elevator that will send you up the tower, all while the dragon quickly dies from TNT and funnels its XP to you. I actually ran this farm for just about 15 minutes and I went from 0 to 43 levels, meaning you can go out side while getting those Minecraft gains. Psych boy, I was playing on my phone, the grind don't stop. Minecraft players didn't stop automating the game there though. YouTuber Taco Technicia created an automated baritone robot that can speedrun and beat Minecraft in its entirety. Baritone is a hacking tool that is usually designed to do simple tasks for you like getting diamonds while you sit back and watch. But the problem with most baritone bots is that they're stupid. If you were to say get iron right when you spawn, it would go straight to mining the iron with this dirt instead of getting a stone pickaxe first. But this Alberto Einstein of Minecraft coded every single step to beating the game into this one baritone bot, as well as PvP skills to where it was able to kill the Ender Dragon in just 3 hours, which has never been done before in the game's history. That's not the first time a crazy accomplishment was made with robots though. On the survival Minecraft server 2b2t, where there are zero rules and you can do whatever you want, players will often assert dominance on each other's teams by building giant obsidian structures in the sky shaped as their team logo. One of these groups, known as the Spawn Masons, programmed 61 different baritone bots to simply use obsidian to build a giant replica of their logo, which consisted of 28 million obsidian. That means if you strung out every single block placed from spawn in one direction, you would literally almost hit Minecraft's border, and it was all built in 1 week. But sometimes players would still rather stick to the basics and push themselves to their limits instead of using robots, which makes some of these accomplishments even more impressive. Kurt J. Mack is an official Guinness World Record holder for the longest walking journey ever done in Minecraft. He started a beta version survival world in 2011, over 10 years ago, with the mission to walk 12 million blocks to the end of Minecraft's map, the Farlands. So far, after an entire decade, he's traveled only about 5 out of the 12 million blocks and is projected to finally reach the Farlands sometime in 2030. Now, you might have thought that Ender Dragon farm from earlier was insane, but just take a look at this mock speed guardian farm. This is what YouTuber Nembomb calls the guardian mosh pit, which I mean, just look how much guardians this farm produces per second, and you can see why it's called that. It's actually really interesting how this thing works. Basically, if you remove the blocks from an ocean monument and kill the guardians, they will all respawn instantly as long as there's water. This feature can be manipulated by replacing every single spawn point for the guardians with nether portals, which will basically trap them and instantly teleport them into the Nether to be killed. This will create an infinite loop of guardians, which causes this constant blob of fish to be produced. And despite how goofy this thing looks, it's actually the best way to get XP in the entire game. So all of these accomplishments have taken place in the game, but well, this next guy ended up lighting his house on fire while streaming Minecraft. I mean, it isn't really an accomplishment, but it's probably a world's first, so I think it deserves to be in here. Am I right, guys? Anyways, this man paused Minecraft to light a mess. match, and he ended up putting the match on a bunch of paper after, which then caught flame, and from there, his fate was sealed. You really just can't make this up, but, you know, luckily, him and his family got out safely in the end, and that, kids, is why you don't smoke. Alright, so next, we gotta look at a speedrun and seed discovery. Here's the record-breaking seed for the fastest end entrance category. The seed starts off by spawning you on a deserted island. Nothing too special, but if you go into the cave system underneath you, you will literally find the stronghold with a completely filled end portal right in front of your eyes. This seed's discovery sparks the current world record for the end entrance category, which is about 17.46 seconds. This next accomplishment is possibly the greatest and most insane build that has ever been done in Minecraft. It's the whole Earth. The Build the Earth project is a huge team of builders working together to rebuild every single city and country on Earth in Minecraft, some of which being places like New York, Munich, and London. This map right here actually shows you all of the progress they've made. Each one of these circled zones on the map is a region that has been completely built. Let's check out Oklahoma real quick. Oh boy, what a surprise! There's nothing there because there's nothing in Oklahoma! This next accomplishment also involves a really insane build, but the real wonders of the structure lies not within the architecture, but the libraries inside. This absolute beautiful building was made to contain banned books and pieces of media that oppressive governments in certain countries have banned. And because no countries have actually banned Minecraft, any free thinkers from oppressive countries can hop on the craft and see over hundreds of books their government has been hiding from them. You know Bedrock, the unbreakable block? Well, the members of the Prototech Minecraft server made a contraption to obtain Bedrock in survival. Not just break it, actually get the item. It's a very complex process, but to do this, they basically find the precise spot an end gateway will spawn, and then they place a slime block exactly where the Bedrock is going to generate. When this is done, they go to a nearby TNT cannon and use it to enderpearl themselves into the chunks extremely quickly before the end gateway can even load into the world. As you can see here, the chunks aren't fully loaded yet. But when they break the slime block they placed earlier, the chunk finally updates and the game gets confused, dropping a Bedrock block instead. How people had the IQ to solve something like this, I don't know, but curing cancer, no, this is way better. Once again, back on the Prototech Minecraft server, RazeWorks and his team figured out how to create this insane looking lightning farm, which produces an infinite supply of skeleton horsemen. You probably don't believe me, but yes, this isn't survival Minecraft. Basically, what the team did was fill up every possible chunk around the farm lightning could strike in with massive amounts of lava, which, because of reasons in the game's code, lightning will not be able to strike on that lava, so it's forced to strike exactly where the farm is. Then by using complex redstone to quickly load chunks off in the distance, they manipulate the game to strike lightning down 20 times a second, ultimately gathering over thousands of skeleton horsemen per hour. There's also other forms of RNG manipulation done too, with similar techniques like Skycraft's interesting looking witch farm, and honestly, these are just accomplishments that deserve spots with cavemen making fire. This next accomplishment completely one-ups the 1 million gold block cube and drained out nether from earlier. It is a 1,000 by 1,000 or 80 million block hole of nothingness. Everything in it is completely dug out, even the bedrock, all done in survival mode on the Skycraft server. This was done by first using multiple different TNT flying bomber planes to destroy all of the surface blocks, and then sophisticated redstone machines were used to break the bedrock with a piston glitch. Like, bro, just look at this stuff on screen right now. What is going on? The goal of this project was to make a playable skyblock map in survival. So if you were to go onto the islands they made right in the middle, you would have no idea you were actually in a regular Minecraft world. Out of every single achievement shown so far in this video, none of them come as close to the accomplishment of creating artificial intelligence in Minecraft. Organizations like MineRL have practically created a human brain in the world of Minecraft that learns different behaviors based off of punishments and rewards by itself. For example, they started off by putting these group of robots into a new world with no prior knowledge of the game at all, as if a human was thrown onto Earth for the first time. The robots were then given points based on the type of blocks they mined, so as time went on, these robots learned what blocks give more points, like diamonds, and what blocks to avoid mining, all from their own judgment. The fact that people literally created evolving and learning robots in Minecraft is just a crazy accomplishment, and the scary part is that one day, these AI might learn to be better Minecraft players than you, me, and George not found? And that's Minecraft's greatest accomplishment. So wait a minute, we forgot about one? Oh, a build? All right, let's check it out real quick.